tabloid.
With so much power.
The power to manipulate us with one picture.
With one sentence.
All while destroying our personal and professional reputation.
But are they all really run by underhanded conmen that will do anything for an exclusive picture?
I guess we'll have to find out.
Look at all of these headlines. Are they all really true?
Well, one of the most accurate tabloid magazines is Us Weekly. It has a 35% cover accuracy, while the overall accuracy is 59%.
What? If that's the most accurate, then what's the least?
OK Magazine. It has 7% cover accuracy, while the issue is only 14%.
And I'm guessing every other magazine up there isn't far off?
You're right. In fact, these are the magazines that the public reads the most frequently, yet they are also some of the least accurate.
Wow, I wonder what the truth is behind each headline someone writes, considering the cover issue is usually the least accurate.
I mean, we should figure it out.
What about Taylor Swift and Harry Styles? Everyone thinks they're dating, and I bet they're gonna write a story on that.
You're right. Let's figure out what goes into the making of a headline.
We have to have another story to write about.
But nothing's happening. All the celebrities are being, for once, normal.
Unless we make our own stories.
What are you talking about?
It has been proven that about 75% of Americans believe almost everything they read. So why can't we go so far to see how far we can manipulate them?
I know exactly what you mean. I have a plan.
Look at Taylor Swift in those high heels. She's gonna fall right down those stairs and into Harry Styles' arms, and we'll be there to catch the whole thing.
Come on, follow me.
And now we're back on E! News, and we have new pictures of Taylor Swift holding hands with the one and the only Harry Styles. Sorry, girls, but it looks like Taylor is true.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe this!
What is it?
Taylor's been confirmed! My life is over!
It's true! They were holding hands and going to their hotel!
I can't believe she's taking my Harry! I hate her!
I can't believe you ignorant little girls really did believe what we wrote in that tabloid.
What? What do you mean? Who are you?
And what do you mean, ignorant?
You and everyone who believes our stories is being manipulated.
She's right. I mean, we usually don't share what goes on behind the scenes of the tabloids to anyone, but you girls need some serious help.
Okay, but how can we tell what's not? Is everything fake?
I mean, come on, just give us some tips.
Well, there are about three ways to tell if something is true or not.
Oh, I think I know one. A lot of the photos in the tabloids have been retouched to distort our reality.
Wow, maybe you guys know more than we thought.
She's right. Many photos in the tabloids have been retouched. That taints our perspective on what the person really looks like.
That's true. Look at this picture of she looks way different in her before and after shots.
I mean, look at her hair. They made the bottom of it more blonde. And look at her eyebrows. They filled it in and made them more defined.
And look how they fixed her makeup. They also made her eyes look so much brighter and piercing.
To tell if something has been photoshopped, like this, look for smooth porcelain-like skin. No one really has perfect skin.
Did you know that 100% of the photos you see in high fashion magazines have been photoshopped according to idealbite.com? So everyone wants perfect skin like a model. But now how do you feel, knowing it's all an illusion?
But what about the real stories in the tabloids? How do we know they're not true?
Well, most people say they got their information from a reliable source, when really they're just making up assumptions.
So what you're saying is that the stories in the tabloids are just that, stories with absolutely no truth?
No, it depends on if you have a reliable source.
That's so true. Look at Kourtney Kardashian, for example. People thought she was engaged just from one misleading headline.
You're right. On November 20th, 2012, Star magazine claimed that Kourtney Kardashian and Scott Disick were engaged. Star stated that Scott popped the question while they were in Paris on vacation.
Well, I mean, it looks pretty real. They've been dating for a while.
Actually, Kourtney's sister Kim repeatedly denied this false rumor. Look, here's proof.
This magazine sources must have been way off.
But in the issue it says sources confirm they're engaged. Doesn't that mean the source is reliable?
Absolutely not. Unless a magazine has something that proves it to be true, like a quote or a video of an actual interview, you can't trust it. So don't be fooled by the whole sources say line.
But I know your next question is going to be, what if it's a quote from a real person? Then it's guaranteed to be true, right? No.
But if the celebrity is saying it themselves, then how could it not be reliable?
Well, sometimes a celebrity says something they don't mean. And when taken out of context, it has a totally different meaning when it's not in the actual interview.
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about. Remember when Robert Pattinson was on Oprah? They were joking around in the interview while they were filming the show.
Oh, I remember. Oprah was asking Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart personal questions, and then Pattinson jokingly said, "Ha ha, Kristen's pregnant."
He obviously didn't mean it, and everyone watching the show knew it was just a joke to change the subject from Oprah's hard-hitting questions. This is the video where this occurred.
But of course, it was taken out of context when OK Magazine plastered "Rob tells Oprah Kristen's pregnant" all over the issue.
I really can't believe you all do this to trick people who have done nothing to you.
Yeah, how come you all can get away with this?
Excuse me, but it's you all that believe it.
Well, how do you make the tabloids so believable? Maybe if we knew how you manipulated us, we wouldn't fall into the tabloids' trap.
She's right. I mean, how can we expect you all to know what's true and what's not if you don't know the techniques we use? That's why we created this, our very own TLS tabloid.
Look, teachers talk to the TLS tabloid. Looks like it's a special teacher's edition.
Did you notice how the title starts with all T's? It's called an alliteration. It pulls the reader in and gets them more interested about the story.
And look how big the pictures are. They leave almost no space for text.
That's a very common occurrence in the tabloids. Often the pictures are huge, and the text is limited with almost no detail.
And look, even...
Mr. Harrington is finally getting married to Kelly Casey.
And look at the title, it even rhymes.
That's also a common technique. The headline is one of the most important parts of the tabloid. So in order to pull the people in, they use slang, misspelled words, and even rhyming. They also use bold adjectives.
The end is finally here. Did you know that the tabloids put their big points or their main endings in the end of the magazine? Well, I guess Ms. Bonzo has a message for upcoming 6th and 7th grade students.
If that's not an intense ending, then I don't know what is.
Miss Bonzo just wants to love all the children.
Hopefully, now that you've heard our tips about the tabloids, you will not be fooled by them anymore. I mean, before you came in here, you didn't know what went into the making of a tabloid, but now you do.
So next time you're reading a tabloid, ask yourself,
are you being manipulated?